It is time now to head into the chat room, and joining me today is 973 FM breakfast host Bianca Dye in Brisbane and NBN Hello. Presenter Gavin Morris in Newcastle. Good hey afternoon guys. To both of you. Happy Monday.
Good afternoon.
Happy
Thank you.
Monday.
Now, first up today, the children of terrorist Khalid Sharouf are headed home to Australia as part of a secret operation that is being backed by the federal government. It comes after years of debate about their future. Let's go first to you, Gav. What do you think? Should the Australian government allow these kids to come back to their country?
I think the government has made the correct decision here. I don't think it's one that they took lightly. It was certainly not an easy decision. But in the end, it is, I think, the correct one. And hopefully it all ends in a beautiful story. I mean, this is really an incredible story of love from their grandmother and what she has gone through. It's just an extraordinary story. I can see the movie script. Yes. I can see Meryl Streep playing Karen's role. It's just an extraordinary story of love. I understand some of the concerns. I mean, fear is a great driving force behind many, I think, in Australia that are probably leaning towards that they shouldn't have come home. But I don't think there's too much to fear here. These children had no say, no choice in what they were thrown into by their parents. And they shouldn't, you know, pay the price of their parents' decisions all the way back then. And they've got a lot here. They've got love. I mean, criminology, it's not passed down through DNA. It's usually circumstantial. It's poverty, your environment. Take the kids out of what they are surrounded by at the moment, and it is absolutely squalid circumstances. Bring them back to Australia, shower them with love, and as I said, I think it'll be a good news story in the long run.
I agree with you to a point, and I totally think that kids, you know, shouldn't be made to serve for their parents. My worry is if, when by the time they come teenagers or adults, do they then look to their parents and idolise them and go, well, if that's what my parent thought, well, maybe they had a point, and go down that path? I don't know, Bianca, what do you think?
Well, a couple of them are already teenagers now. That's the thing. They're already teenagers. So the thing is, you know, there's actually a photo of his youngest son, Abdullah, holding a severed head. That's a famous photo. So I'm not saying that these kids are necessarily going to go down that line, but the worry there, and I'm not saying any child ever wants to be in a refugee camp. I mean, these
He's no longer with us. You realise that. He's no longer here.
That
child is no longer alive, but he does have other children that are coming back to Australia.
Yes, the younger ones. But what I'm saying is they've all grown up in that environment.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? So I'm not saying they're going to go on to do that themselves. I'm just saying, yes, they have to come back here. They're young kids. They didn't have a choice. As long as you say, the grandmother and whoever is here is surrounding them and letting them know that that's not okay. Like, what their dad did is not okay. It's just, it's a horrible, awkward circumstance. These poor kids have got no one else to turn to, but it's still a yucky situation.
Yeah, it sure is. All right, let's move on. And studying at uni might seem like a wise career move, but according to a report out today, the lifelong earnings of a tradie can actually be higher than uni graduates. Now, figures from the federal government's Job Outlook website show some tradies could earn around $3 million over a 40-year career, while a uni-qualified human resource manager or an advertising executive would earn closer to $2.8 million. Sounds like a lot, but I guess it is over 40 years. Bianca, given this report, do you think society puts too much expectation on going to uni and getting a high-paid job?
Yeah, absolutely. Do you know how many tradies I know have property portfolios? And how many uni students I know are the best baristas you've ever seen? it's crazy, but it's true. And it's funny because I started to go to journalism. I started a Bachelor of Arts in Media Journalism at Melbourne Uni, and I ended up not finishing it. And I joined the circus, and then I became a performer.
Actually join the circus?
I actually joined the Moscow Circus and traveled.
I love it. There you go. I didn't know that about you.
Yep. Anyway, and then I did voiceovers, and then I got into radio and la la la. So I don't think you have to have a university degree to necessarily be successful in life. I know tradies that earn a squillion, and I don't think you necessarily have to go to uni. I think there is a lot of pressure. Learn the trade. I did work experience at Channel 9 when I was like 15, and I sort of worked my way up that way and knew what I wanted to do.
Gav, what do you think?
Oh, look, most of my tradie mates seem very happy in life. They've got a beautiful balance, haven't they? I mean, they pick and choose their jobs.
Is that the 3 p.m. knock-off time?
Yeah, you bet. But, you know, look, I mean, the other part of this equation that isn't really in the story, when you're a tradie, you've actually got a mate that's a plumber, one that's an electrician, one that knows how to pour concrete, you know, one that can do the renos.
Yeah.
So, you know, you have this incredible pool of people that you can draw on when you're doing renovations. If you're an accountant, it's like, man, you got to pay top dollar to get the Sparky in while they're all doing mates rates to fix the house up, you know.
Yes.
So there's a lot of benefits there. But, you know, I mean, yeah, just do what you're good at. That's the best thing, best tip you can give to your children and make them go out and go for it. Those hex debts. Oh, man, that is brutal,
yeah,
isn't it? It's a brutal way to start your career.
I only just paid mine off, yes, and yeah. I didn't even finish.
I reckon be a plumber. I always seem to be paying a lot of money for plumbers.
Yes.
My mate's job, you know, description or what he has on the back of his van is like, no job too small.
And businesses say that a ban on shopping bags has contributed to our weakening economy. They say people are only buying what they can carry without a bag or that they can fit into the one or two bags that they've remembered to bring along, unlike me. I don't think I've remembered once. Gav, what do you think?
My favourite meme of the year is that chimpanzee when he's holding all of the oranges.
The oranges!
It's done the round. He's got him in his feet and he's got him in the hands. You know, I mean, that's all I can ever think of when I go shopping these days. It's like, what can I carry to the car? You know, I think overall, look, the real estate industry has gone through an adjustment. The supermarket industry obviously going through an adjustment phase here as well. Let's remember that 40% of what we were putting in our refrigerators we threw out if we're...
Yes.
Yes, I don't know.
It was a good thing.
I'm a spontaneous shopper, so I never remember
my bag.
So it's really about what I can fit into my handbag or whatever else I have with me. Bianca, what do you think?
My life.
She could juggle the oranges.
I literally write... I literally write bags on my hand every time I go shopping. Amber, I'm like you. I never remember. I think, oh, I need to pick up some carrots and some chicken and some chicken stock. I'm going to whip up a soup. The bags are in the boot of the car and they're like five escalators away.
To get them in the car. I rarely remember to even get them in the car in the first place. And then if I have remembered, they stay there and I'm at the checkout aisle and they're like, do you have your own bags? I'm like, yeah, but they're a long way away.
That's what I say. You know what? They need to start a hashtag. Bag guilt, because the little chick packing your bags goes, do you want some bags today? And I go, oh God, yeah, okay, here we go. And you feel so bad, right? I feel so bad for the environment. I've got 80 of those bloody things in my cupboard.
Yeah, the pantry's full of the two bottom shelves are just all plastic bags now, aren't they?
It's like 15 cents. They need to make the bags $2, and then people would go, oh, you know what?
Yeah, but then we wouldn't buy the extra stuff, and that's what businesses are complaining about.
And that's what's going around.
All right, new research has found people should spend at least 2 hours a week out in nature. Scientists say doctors should prescribe it to people just like they recommend exercise. Bianca, apparently it's a magic 2 hours a week in the outdoors. It's the right time for adults to boost good health and well-being. But is it realistic?
You know what? 2 hours sounds like a lot, but it's actually not. And I think it's amazing. I am a massive advocate for mental health. I'm an ambassador for Are You OK? And honestly, when I go out into nature, I was diagnosed with generalized anxiety disorder when I was 29. And I complain all the time. I'm anxious. I don't have time for stuff. When I make the time, when I prioritize the time to go and get into nature and be around green, I instantly calm down, I instantly feel good, my anxiety dissipates. And I can tell you, when I got diagnosed as well with adrenal exhaustion, all these things, an Indian doctor said to me the best thing I could do was to go outside with bare feet first thing in the morning and put my bare feet into the morning dew grass.
Really?
And stand there for 5 minutes and it would just energise my body. I also drink water.
Have you tried that?
From the full moon, like Victoria Beckham, so don't believe anything I say.
Gav, we have 20 seconds left. What do you think of this advice?
Oh, typical Queenslander, barefoot for like an hour. During the past week, everybody would have had frostbite on their toes here first thing in the morning.
Yes,
it's been brutal
down here. Right.
Look, absolutely 100%. You know, it changes your mindset. My little weekends away flying, surfing, everything is adjusted perfectly and balanced again at one with the universe once you return.
Got to leave it there, Bianca and
Namaste.
Gavin. Thank you so much for being on Chat Room.